Augmented reality is a powerful new way to understand 3D data. Since FME is so good at transforming data and converting different formats, we wanted to see if we could display 3D objects created by FME in a custom augmented reality app. I sat down with Angus for a demo. You've been playing with augmented reality lately, right?
Mm-hmm.
The Apple one?
Yeah.
And that's through ARKit, right?
Yeah, that's through ARKit. Yeah. You can use your iPhone or iPad, and it can put some virtual 3D models on your screen with the environment also on the same screen blend together. So you can move around and you can move into it and see the model in details. So if I go to my Dropbox and then select a file, it will download the file, and when it detects enough information, it will put their model on the plane. Yeah, you can try if you want.
And then, so where did you get this object from?
This is from SketchUp, but I translate to OBJ. ARKit has some limitation about the formats it supports. We are only able to open OBJ files for now.
So if you've got an object in a different format, then you just need to convert that into OBJ and you can see it in ARKit? Okay,
yeah. Nice.
Our developers leveraged ARKit, Apple's augmented reality framework, which can render 3D objects in OBJ format. When someone wants to use FME to see a 3D object in augmented reality, FME will zip up the OBJ file along with any associated textures and name the zip file with the FME AR extension. You can then upload this to the cloud and use our AR app to see it on an iPhone or iPad.
We are actually planning to release the app. We're trying to submit the app to App Store. We will need to polish it a little bit. And we are planning to submit it to the App Store. Hopefully it will be available sometime around our FME 2018.0 release.
It's more writing though. Like we're not gonna, well, do you think we'll have to read augmented reality data?
Well, I think it's, right now what I can see is they are still just normal 3D data, and their augmented reality is actually their one endpoint. Mm-hmm. So it's more like we provide the data to the app, and then people can use the device, either a headset or an iOS device to view it. So that's probably the direction that
That makes sense. It's more of like a means of delivery. So you've got the data in a certain format, and then the means of delivery is, it happens to be an augmented reality headset, but it could also be like a web application or anything else.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not an output format, it's like a delivery system. Coming soon, the plan is to make the app open source on GitHub and publish it as a free app on the iOS App Store.